Hello, my name is Ioannis Gkougkoustamos, and today I will be presenting the study Earth Intelligence to provide accurate and timely knowledge about shortchanging in an island context with large tourist infrastructure by combining multi-source Earth observation and spatial open big data. The main objective is to combine multiple information regarding shoreline change measurements, vertical deformation measurements, and land cover types in a single product that can be used for monitoring shorelines. Such a product is particularly important for determining socioeconomic and environmental effects and assessing future changes and risks. In this case, the focus is on the shoreline erosion and coastal zone subsidence of Rhodes Island using remote sensing data and methods. Rhodes is the biggest island in the Greek Dodecanese insular complex of the southeastern Aegean Sea. Geologically, it is located in the easternmost part of the Hellenic Arc and has intense offshore seismicity. It is one of the most popular international Greek tourist destinations and it has a vast increase of seasonal population. The economy depends mainly on tourism and most of the touristic activities and infrastructures are concentrated along the coasts of the island. The study is carried out in three sections. The first section is the calculation and mapping of shoreline change rates, the second section is the calculation and mapping of the coastal zone's vertical velocity rates, and the third section is the spatial combination of shoreline change rates, vertical velocity rates, and Korean land cover. 15 Sentinel-2 images were used, 128 ascending and 103 descending Sentinel-1 images were used, 3 SRTM dams, and vector data of Natura 2000 protected areas, settlements, and Korean land cover. The processing of optical multispectral images is based on two methods, the NTWI and the linear regression method. The normalized difference water index is a band ratio method that uses the reflected green light and near-infrared radiation. It allows for the separation of the land from the sea and therefore the mapping of the shoreline for each year. Detection and calculation of shoreline change rates is achieved with a digital shoreline analysis system of the USGS. It uses specific tools to generate measurement points in the shoreline and then it uses the linear regression method to calculate the rates in meters per year. The processing of radar images is based on the multitemporal synthetic aperture radar interferometry technique. It uses multiple ascending and descending SAR acquisitions of an area and calculates the vertical velocity rates of specific targets based on their phase differences in millimeters per year. After the calculation of the shoreline change rates and vertical velocity rates of the coastal zone, the two results are spatially combined together with Korean land cover data. For each shoreline change measurement, the nearest vertical velocity measurements are averaged in order to estimate the general vertical movement of the area. As a result, each shoreline change measurement is accompanied by an average vertical velocity rate of the immediate area and land cover type. The processing of Sentinel-2 images shows that 174.5 km of shoreline are stable, 12.9 km of shoreline have accretion, and 57.3 km of shoreline have erosion. Processing of Sentinel-1 images shows that 83,611 measurement points are stable, 19,038 points show uplift, and 7,877 points show subsidence. This is the final product. When a shoreline measurement is selected, it shows the following information: shoreline change rate, average vertical velocity rate of the immediate area, and Korean land cover type. Specifically for this study, the focus was on erosion only. Erosion on subsided ground is detected at 1.1 km near the settlement of Apolakia. Erosion on stable ground is detected at 53.2 km, and erosion on uplifted ground in 3 km. This study led to some very important conclusions about the shoreline of Rhodes Island. Most of the shoreline change rates show a stable shoreline. Erosion affects coastal areas with sports and leisure facilities, continuous and discontinuous urban fabric, and sections of Natura 2000 protected areas. Moreover, most of the vertical velocity measurements show a stable coastal zone. Some subsidence measurements are located in the coastal zone near the settlement of Apolakia, while in the rest of the coastal zone, the subsidence measurements are scattered. Therefore, erosion is not a direct result of subsidence, as most of it takes place on stable and uplifting ground. In conclusion, shoreline change rates and vertical velocity rates of the coastal zone were estimated. Their spatial combination with Korean land cover open spatial data led to the generation of a single product in the form of a KMZ file that contains triple geospatial information, erosion or accretion, subsidence or uplift, and land cover type. This information is stored in the measurements that are located across the shoreline and the user can instantly get it by selecting any measurement of the area that they are interested. In the future, knowledge from geospatial data such as economics, geological formations, sea level change, and bathymetry could be added in order to have a more complete product with more information. Thank you for your time.